Very good morning, my dear children. So today we are going to discuss about the fifth lesson, the fourth class science fifth lesson, parts of a plant. Here this is the part three. So last session we have discussed first part. We have discussed about the root, and next part we have discussed about the stem, and now we are going to discuss about the part leaf. Yes, here we are going to discuss about the leaf. See, my dear children, the leaf is doing many jobs. Yes, no? See, before in ancient times, actually the leaves, by using the leaves only, the person they used to cover their body. So not with the stem or with the roots, they used to cover their body with the leaves only. Not only that, and some of the leaves like neem leaves are helpful to our body to make us to be healthy. And if you eat that leaves, it will be so helpful. And whatever waste will be there in our body, it will be removed by that leaves. And removed by that leaves. And you can see, and some of the houses also, they used to cover with the leaves only. So these many advantages we are having about the leaves. So what are the function of the leaves? What the leaves are doing? Actually, the main function of the leaf, the main function of the leaf is that there are mainly three jobs we are having. One, the first one is that it is making the food. The leaves are preparing the food. What is the first one, ma? The leaf. It makes the food. And second one is that it takes carbon dioxide in and it releases the oxygen. Carbon dioxide means in the molecular formula we can write CO2. Understand, ma? CO2 means carbon dioxide. So here I am writing simply. I am not writing full form. CO2 means what, my dears? Carbon dioxide. It takes in carbon dioxide and throws out or as it releases oxygen. So next, and the third job is that it will be rid of extra water. It gets rid of extra water. It gets rid of extra water. So here now we are going to discuss about each and every part. The first point. So here you can see the first point. What is the first point, ma? It makes the food. So the leaf is preparing the food, na? So by using, you know that the leaf is preparing the food by using what are the materials like carbon dioxide, water, and sunlight, chlorophyll. So by using these, the leaf is preparing the food. Out of these, if one material is lack also, the leaf cannot able to prepare the food. So this process is nothing but we call photosynthesis. The process of preparation of food by using the, see, what is photosynthesis, ma? The preparation of photosynthesis. What is the photosynthesis, my dears? The process of making food. Write these in a homework book, or a homework book you can write these. The process of making food by using carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll, and sunlight. This is called photosynthesis. This process is nothing but we call the photosynthesis. During this process, it releases oxygen and what it releases, during this process it releases the food means sugar and sugar means food, like what we are going to prepare, that is a food. It releases the oxygen. So here this process is nothing but we call photosynthesis. So here how it is to prepare the food, it is using the carbon dioxide, water, chlorophyll and sunlight. Actually what happened, from where the leaf is getting the carbon dioxide, from the air. So in the air we are having many gases, no, nitrogen, oxygen, hydrogen, carbon dioxide, these many, still many gases we are having. Out of those, the leaf is absorbing the carbon dioxide. What it is absorbing, it is taking the carbon dioxide. How it is, which part of the plant is absorbing the carbon dioxide? Leaf. The leaf is absorbing the carbon dioxide. Here you can see the leaf is absorbing the carbon dioxide. Actually on the leaf there will be a tiny pores. On the leaf there will be a tiny pores. Pores means small holes you see. So those are very tiny pores. Those you can't able to see directly using your eyes. We can see those pores by using only telescope. So these tiny pores is nothing but we call stomata. What we call those tiny pores, ma? Tiny pores. Those we call stomata. The tiny pores which are present on the leaf, those are called stomata. So the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the tiny pores, stomata. And what happened? Already the water, we have discussed before session that the water is carried by the stem. So the water and minerals are reaching to the leaf, and here the carbon dioxide also absorbed by the leaf. Then what the leaf will do, inside the leaf the carbon dioxide and water both are combined, and it is preparing the sugar. Sugar means it is a kind of food. So carbohydrates, we can say that carbohydrates also. So it is preparing the carbohydrates. Here actually if you want to do any work, you should need some energy or not. Without energy, even though all materials are there to prepare the food, can you able to prepare the food? No, you should have the energy. So that, from where that energy the leaf is getting? Yes, from the sunlight. The energy is getting. So the energy to prepare the food, by the leaf, it is getting energy from the sun. That is nothing but a sunlight. It is getting the energy to prepare the food from the sunlight. And from the root it is getting water and minerals. Already what is presented in the leaf? Chlorophyll. There is a substance in the leaf that is nothing but we called chlorophyll. See the chlorophyll, why the leaf is appears in a green color, you know, because of the substance chlorophyll only. Here what is the use of chlorophyll? It making the leaf to be appears in the green color. And not only that, actually here the sunlight is absorbing by the leaf. No, who is catching that sunlight? The chlorophyll substance only. Here what is presented, ma? Chlorophyll. Understand, my dear? So here the carbon dioxide is absorbed by the leaf through the stomata. What is the stomata? The tiny pores. Pores means small holes, like holes it is used to be. The tiny pores present on the leaf is nothing but a stomata. Here these are not writing, you have to write in your notebook. That's what I am repeating second time. So here the tiny pores present on the leaf is called a stomata. Through that stomata the leaf is absorbing the carbon dioxide. And the substance which is present in the leaf is nothing but a chlorophyll. What is the use of chlorophyll? The chlorophyll is giving color to the leaf, which is appears in green color. And also the chlorophyll is helping to catch the sunlight, to trap the sunlight, which is used to prepare for the food and the water and minerals are minerals we are the water and minerals we are getting from the roots through the stems. So inside the leaf the carbon dioxide and water are combined by using the sunlight and chlorophyll, then finally it is preparing the food item. It means that like sugars, sugar is nothing but like a carbohydrates. So this process is nothing but we call a photosynthesis. Simply we can write this in the form of an equation. So in the form of an equation, photosynthesis. See here I am writing it. So what is combining carbon dioxide? So carbon dioxide, along with the carbon dioxide, what we are taking? Water. By using whom? Sunlight. Who is capturing that sunlight? Chlorophyll. You no need to buy a tray. Just a process. See here, carbon dioxide and water are combined. In the who is giving energy to prepare food? Sunlight. Who is capturing that sunlight? Chlorophyll. And finally, what is giving? Sugar. Sugar means food. Sugar plus what it is releasing along with that? Oxygen. That oxygen is thrown out by the leaf. This process is nothing but we call photosynthesis. Here I told no photosynthesis. Photosynthesis. Here you can see photosynthesis is actually the word photo. It means that if any work or any job is done by the light, then we can use the word photo. What we can use ma? Word photo. If any work is done by the light, the work done by light, then we can call it as a photo. Here the food is preparing by using the light only, so that here that's what we are using the word photo. And synthesis means preparing the food or as any substance, preparing the substance by using one or by using two or more materials. If you are preparing anything by using either two materials or more than two materials, that we can call as a synthesis. So here we are using, by using two materials we are synthesizing food na, and by using whom? In the presence of a sunlight. That's what by combining we call this process as photosynthesis. Understand ma? So by using this process the leaf is preparing the food. It is the first job of the leaf. What is the next one? It takes in carbon dioxide and releases oxygen. Here you can see carbon dioxide it is taking, and here you can see oxygen it is releasing. This happens during morning time, during daytime. On other side, this is during night time. So during daytime what happens? The carbon dioxide is absorbed by the leaf and oxygen is throws out, releases outside. Actually during the daytime only the sun used to be present na, we'll get the leaf is getting the sunlight no, the sunlight to prepare the food, the energy we are getting from the sunlight no. In night times there will be no sunlight, then the leaf cannot have energy to prepare the food, so that it doesn't need any carbon dioxide at the night time. It need only oxygen in the night time because for the respiration. See the plants also for their respiration they will use the oxygen only. So rest of the oxygen they will take for their respiration, and rest of the oxygen they leaves out. Here during the daytime means they will prepare the food, they need the carbon dioxide. At the time some of the oxygen it will use for respiration, and carbon dioxide it will be used for preparing the food, and remaining oxygen it will be sent outside during the daytime. Understood, my dear? You keep it in mind. During the daytime, the leaf is absorbing the carbon dioxide and releases the oxygen because to prepare the food. And for respiration, it will use some oxygen. Rest of that, it will be releases. And but during the night time, there is no preparation of food, so that it doesn't need any carbon dioxide. Whatever carbon dioxide will be there, it releases outside. It needs, but it will be to alive it. It needs oxygen for respiration, no? So it takes the oxygen in the night time. That's what your grandparents used to suggest, that night times we should not sleep under the tree. Yes, no? Have you listened that word, under the tree? We know we should not sleep under the tree during night time, because we cannot get oxygen properly. Whatever oxygen will be there, it will be shared by the tree also. Then we'll get the less oxygen level. But during the daytime, we'll get more oxygen, so we can sit or sleep under the tree, because this is the reserve. Understand, ma? This is the second job of the leaf. And what is the other job of the leaf? It gets rid of extra water. Rid of means releases, sending out. Understood? Releases or is sending out. That we call rid of. So you know that the leaf are taking the water to prepare the food, na? Still, whatever extra water is there, that extra water will be released by the leaf by using the process of transpiration. What is the process, ma? Transpiration. That process we call transpiration. This is the third. This is the second job. So third one, transpiration. What is transpiration? The process of getting rid of extra water is called transpiration. So if the leaf is releasing whatever extra water it is having, it is releasing. See, we are whatever extra water is there in our body, how we are losing in the form of the sweat, no? It is we are getting in the form of a sweat. Like that, the leaves also, it is just sending out some extra, whatever extra water is there, it is sending outside. If you have a doubt, we are having one activity. It was already we have done many times, but now due to this corona time, I can't able to do under your presence. See, you just take two leaves, ma. Means along with the stem you can take leaves. The stem must have the leaves. See, here you can take the stem which is having the leaves. So that you can cover with the one cover, polythene cover we are having, no, transparent polythene cover. You can cover that part. Still roots will be there. The roots can be outside, no problem. So only the roots can be outside, no problem. So but the leaves, all the leaves must be in the cover. So you have to close the cover. Completely have to close the cover. Polythene cover. And here you take one more stem with the leaves, ma. So here what you will do, you apply a grease on the surface of the leaf. You can apply the grease. So on the surface of the leaf you can apply a grease, and this also you can cover with the transparent cover, and you just keep under the sunlight sometime. Means just 15 minutes or 10 minutes, like that it is enough. So after 10 or 15 minutes, if you observe, then you can find some water droplets inside the polythene cover. Here you can see out of these two, which one, in which one you can able to find the water droplets. You can find the water droplets in the first case. In the second polythene bag, you can't able to find any water droplets, because here actually the leaf is used to the whatever water is presented, that water is used to be evaporate ma. That process is nothing but we call transpiration. Here what happened, when the water is evaporating, we have covered with the polythene cover ma. Then there is no chance of escaping for the water vapor outside, so that whatever water is that will be converted in the form of water droplets on the surface of the cover only. On the surface of the cover only the water used to be forms as a water droplets. And then why madam, in the second case, also leaves only, no, we have covered with the polythene cover only, no, still why in the second case we doesn't get? Actually the water is released through the stomata. Through what the water is releasing? Through the stomata. See here, there is a stomata, tiny pores are presented, no? Through that the water is getting rid extra water. So but here in the second case what we have done, on the leaf we have just applied the grease. So what happened, wherever the tiny pores are there, that tiny pores are covered, filled with grease. What, or it's a Vaseline, you can use it. Vaseline means very good. You have filled that tiny pores with the Vaseline. Then what happens? You have covered a layer, like a layer, no? So that the water, to evaporate the water, we are not giving any chance to the water to evaporate. Understand ma? If that Vaseline is not used, then here also you can find the water droplets. If you are using the Vaseline, you can't find the water droplets. So here only the same, understood right? So here transpiration process is happening or not? It is sending the extra water na? And here in the second case you can see one more thing. You may hear the cactus plant, no? In the, this is your, the cactus plant is used to grow in the desert. There we know that very lack of water, means lack means very less water. So the plant should store the water, or else it cannot get every time, like here how we are giving water to the plants. So it cannot get water every time, it has to store water. It should not loss it water. So to avoid the loss of water, what should we do? We should stop the transpiration process. So how to stop? Actually, how the cactus plant is able to alive in the desert region also, because in the, on the cactus picture I showed now. See here, the cactus picture, here you can see. Actually, the stem is there, no? The stem. That part is used to be covered with, the green color one is used to be covered with a waxy layer. Actually, for the cactus plant itself, no person is applied any Vaseline or anything. By birth itself means it is the specialty of that plants, na, cactus plants. So here means adoptional, we can say adoptional qualities of that plant, that is. So here there is a thick waxy layer present on the leaf or stem of the cactus plant. Then whatever tiny pores are presented on that, those are covered with that waxy layer. So there is no, due to that the water wants to evaporate also, it cannot be evaporate. So the transpiration process is stopped, so that the cactus plant can able to store water to prepare the food and to for their growth. So next part, here we have discussed about the three main jobs of the leaf. One is it makes the food. Next one is that it takes in CO2 and releases oxygen. And third one is that it gets rid of extra water. Still, what are the other jobs of the leaves? You can see not only these three jobs. Still, we are having the job. Still, we are having uses of the leaves. You, before that we have, before, just before I told in the last part, what the leaves, the cactus plant is having the leaves like a spine, thorn. So actually that thorns, that spines, very sharp spines we are finding, no? That spine, that is nothing but leaves, ma. That spines only leaves. So those leaves are not protecting the plant also. Not only the cactus plant, you can see a date palm tree. You can see a date palm means ithakai chetti in telugu. So that date palm tree also, you can find that leaves are very sharp. Sharp it is used to be there. So those leaves are not only preparing the food, ma. It is also protecting the plant from the other animals. So these are the special job of the leaves. This is about the part leaves. My dear children, write these in a running notes in your notebook. And I'll give notes and I'll ask some questions on these also. My dear children, my sincere request is that please read the textbook. So I'm giving some extra questions. Only questions I'm giving to answer you. So those you have to read the textbook and you have to write. Whether it is correct or wrong, don't worry. But you have to whatever you are understanding, you just write those and post it to me. Then I will correct it and I will say what are the mistakes and I will give the correct also. Understand, ma? So, thank you, my dear children.